Hi everybody, I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my craft room. I'm so happy to have you here today, and before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. I know a lot of you aren't, and it is completely free to subscribe, so I'm not sure why you aren't, but make sure that you do. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun crafty content we have coming. It also makes it way easier for you to find any of my tutorials here on YouTube anytime you need them. Now, today's video is one that you guys requested after I made the chip bags, and we're gonna make water bottle labels. These are so fun, so easy, and you're gonna get a free template for these as well so that you can use them in Canva. It's so simple, I promise you. All you need to do is go to corinneblackstone.com/waterbottle, and you are gonna be sent a link for the template so that you can make your own awesome water bottles. It's so fun and really honestly very, very easy. Now let's go ahead and get started. Once you've accessed the free download or the free template from my website, you'll be able to access this, and you're also going to have nutrition facts that you're going to be able to edit as well, but we'll get to those in just a second. But we're going to start with our bottle, and first let me just kind of explain to you the different parts. So these two gray areas are actually going to be where it overlaps and glues together. You'll want to have some color there, but you don't want to put any writing or actual like designs there, or it's going to cut it off. So that's why I have those gray portions there, just to kind of give you a guide. And then this right here will be the front of your bottle. So this will be what can be seen like directly in the front of your bottle. Now you'll be able to delete both of these parts, but leave them for now, but you can honestly get rid of the text. You just click on it and click delete. But what we'll do is we're gonna get an image to put in the middle here, and we're gonna make Encanto themed water bottles. So you can choose any image that you want to, but I think I like this one of Mirabelle right here. I think this one's really cute. So what I'm going to do is click on it, right click, and then save image as. Now keep in mind that these are going to be for personal use only, so don't go selling this, but we can use this for personal use. It's totally fine. I'm going to go ahead and upload that image to my Canva, so I can just drag and drop the image. Now you can see we want Mirabelle to be in the middle, and this is going to be a little bigger. It's going to wrap around a little more, this image that we chose. That's okay. I'm fine with that because we're going to add a few more things to make it so that she looks nice and neat. Now I like to have the guides on because that'll help us make sure that Mirabelle is directly in the center of our design. I think she looks so stinking cute. I love it. I think it's really, really pretty. Now I'm gonna go back to my Encanto search, and there was one that had the casita, and it was just the casita. So I think we're gonna use this image here, which this is the casita. If you don't know, that's the house that they live in. And I'm gonna go ahead and right click on this, and I'm gonna save this image as well. And I'm gonna save it also into my water bottle folder. And then I'm gonna go back to my template and drag and drop the image into my design. Because I think the casita can go over here. And like I said, remember, we're going to have some overlap over here. So this will be perfect because it's going to be able to stretch out a little bit. And it's probably going to cut off just a little edge, but that's okay. But let's say we just wanted to cut off this wood edge here. Like we don't want the trees. Simply click on Mirabelle and go to layer. And you just want to bring her to the front. And that way it cuts off the trees instead of the casita. Now you can make casita larger if you want to, so that it takes up more of your space over here. You do what you want to do. It's really up to you and how you want your design to look. Now we're going to find another image to put over on this side. For this other side, I'm going to use the Disney Encanto design here, this logo. So again, save the image as, save it into that folder, and go back to Canva and drag and drop that file in. This part's really easy. Then we just need to, again, size this so that it fits within our area. Now we do have a little spot where I think it might cut the O off, but if we wrap it correctly, we'll wrap it so that it goes on top of casita and not over the Encanto word. So I'm just gonna kind of size this up and see where I want it. And again, I wanna send this one behind Mirabelle a little bit. So I'm just gonna go to her layer, and I'm just gonna make sure that she's still in the front of our design. And I just kind of wanna play with it and make sure it's not gonna cut off too much of Mirabelle's design. So now that we've got kind of this put together, we can play around with it, add some elements, add some other things. Now we are gonna cover up some of the things like the words Encanto or casita by adding like barcodes and other things to make it look like an actual water bottle.
Now, I said we have this nutrition facts thing that we can edit, which is really fun. So you can edit everything in here, the wording, everything can be edited. But right here, we want to just change this up. And we're going to just change this to, thank you for joining us for, let's make it my birthday, for Corinne's birthday. Now, depending on how long your names are, you may need to adjust the sizing of the font a little bit and the font box. You can just pull it out a little and then make it just a little smaller. Because if your names are longer than like a couple letters, you'll just need to adjust. And then we can add our event date and location. So we'll just make this 5/7/2024. And we're gonna call this Anywhere USA. And you can add anything you want down here to it, whatever you wanna do, it's up to you. Once you've got everything the way you want it, just like in Design Space, I want you to draw a big box, just like you do in Design Space. Use Control C to copy it and go back over to your water bottle and use Control V to paste. Now it's going to be too big, so we're going to reduce the size of it. Now remember, it's going to cut off a little bit of this edge, so I want to move my nutrition facts over a little bit. I'm going to put my nutrition facts just over a little bit of casita. It'll be fine. And I'm going to use a barcode. I'm going to see if I can find one here to use, but you can always find one on Google if you don't have the Canva Pro, but I highly recommend having Canva Pro. I'm just going to grab this little barcode. It's fine. It's part of the Pro account, but like I said, you can grab one off of the Google if you want to. So I'm just going to put the barcode kind of there. And you can really add any other elements that you want to this, whether you want to put like, if it's a specific type of water and you want that, you can add that. You can add like happy birthday on here. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and let's add happy birthday. Now we can use any font we want, but I'm using Pro. So I'm going to use some of their little fun elements here. And I'm just going to change the colors so that they match a little bit better with the design. Let's see. I think that looks pretty good. And then I'll go ahead and make this smaller. Now that's a little hard to see as is. I'm going to go under effects and I want to go ahead and splice it and I'm going to offset it. So I'm just going to play with this a little bit, make it kind of fun, make it kind of pretty. Do what you want with it. Make it however you want. That does not work. I might go, let's see what white looks like. Oh, white looks good. Okay. So we'll do like white and you can, again, add whatever you want. You can add the child's name down here if you want to. Do your own thing, have fun with it. So let's add my name. I'm gonna go ahead and change the color of the font by using the option up here at the top. I don't wanna change all, I just wanna change this font. I'm gonna change this to white. And then I can put that like down here somewhere. Whatever you wanna do, it's up to you. Now that we have our design, it looks really cute, super fun to work with. We're going to go ahead and choose the share option, and I want to download this. Now, you can download this in a lot of different ways. You can download it as a PNG, which you can do for free, a JPG. You can use PDF standard, PDF print, and then when you get into Pro, you can do an SVG. But for this one, I do find that PNG or PDF for print work really good. If you want your Cricut to cut this out, because it can, and I'll show you how to do that, but you can hand cut these as well. I'm going to download it as a PNG. You don't need a transparent background or anything like that, so you're able to do this completely for free. Then I'm going to go ahead and click download, and it may take a second to process, which sometimes it does if it's got like a lot of information. So I'm going to call this water bottle, not with two T's, we're not, water bottle Encanto, and save it. Now let's head over to Cricut so I can show you how to upload this into Cricut. Once you're in Cricut Design Space, simply choose upload, and then you're going to upload your image. Choose browse, and then find where you saved that design. So I saved mine into that water bottle folder. I'm just gonna find that folder. And then I wanna save the water bottle Encanto one. Now this can take a second because it is a PNG. So once it's there, all you have to do is click continue. And we don't have to do anything because we don't have any like background on this that we need to remove. So click apply and continue. And for this one, you want to save it as a flat graphic because we're going to be using this with print and cut. So click continue. And again, you don't have to do anything, but you can like save it into a collection or add tags, whatever you want right there. And then simply click upload. Now with Cricut, it's gonna upload it the wrong size. That's just the nature of Cricut. It's awful. It's annoying. So all I want you to do is change your width to the 8.5 that we were using, and it should have your height about right. If it's off by like 0.002, it's totally fine. I'm not worried about it. That'll be an absolutely fine size. Now, you'll notice that it has this little warning. Ignore that. It just says the image is like poor quality. It's not. It's because Design Space doesn't work well with anything when it comes to print and cut right now. They're having a lot of problems. It's fine. Now, obviously, I want to make more than one, and there's a couple of ways you can do it. So let me show you one way. One way is if you just click make, and it's going to ask you to save it. I'm not going to save it right now. And it's going to put it on to your paper, but you can see you have plenty of room for at least two more, maybe three. But let's change our project copies to three and click apply. So we have room for three per sheet of paper. Now, me personally, I would not likely print these via Design Space. I would rather print them any other way because this wastes a lot of material. I probably could not fit more than three though, so I think it's fine. But once we've got it set to do the three, I'm gonna click continue, and I wanna choose send to printer. And then all I wanna do is set this to print so it prints really nicely. I wanna make sure I have the correct paper size and everything selected, which I see that I don't. Now that it's ready to print, check your page size, make sure it's set to the correct paper size, make sure your printer is correct, and then however many copies you want to do. I find that using the copies section doesn't really work very well. I want to add bleed, and then I want to use my system dialog. That's going to allow me to change some printer settings to make sure that these print nice and crisp and clear so that they come out really, really beautiful. Now, from here, you want to choose preferences. And then again, double check your document size. I want to change my paper. I'm going to change it to the premium photo paper glossy. I can talk. That one works well for me, but you may want to try some of these other ones. I found that the ultra premium, it was a little too much ink on it. Then I want to change my quality from standard to high. Make sure the color is selected and then go to more options. And I want you to turn off the high speed print. That way it doesn't leave you with any lines in your printing. A lot of times if you use the high speed print and keep it on, you're gonna end up with some lines. It's gonna look a little messy. Then simply click okay and click print to send it to your printer. Now I'm printing on brochure paper, which works great for this, but you can print on all sorts of things. Even if you just wanna print it on cardstock, just keep in mind with cardstock, if it gets wet, it may fall off of your bottles. So let's go ahead, get this printed, and then I'm gonna show you how to cut it with your Cricut.
I've got my printout. Now, one thing you want to make sure that you do is that when you load it into your machine, it's going to load the way that it shows on your screen. But I'm going to put it on my mat, and I'm going to use a blue mat. And I am cutting this on the medium cardstock setting. I'm going to go ahead and get this on to my mat. Now, I do want to point out that when it printed a little skewed. So hopefully this will cut out just fine. But I also want to point out how shiny and glossy this paper is. I also want to point out how much light is in my room. I'm going to show you that this is going to read these lines just fine, no issues, even with all of my bright studio lighting, also the natural light that's coming in from the window and everything else, because a lot of people will tell you that you need less light with a glossy material. It's actually not true. I find that more light actually helps. Once it's done, I like to always check my cut, so I'm just gonna kind of peel back my paper and make sure that it cut beautifully. So we'll go ahead and remove these from the mat, and then I'm gonna go ahead and very gently take these off by rolling my mat, and you'll see that they kind of fall off on their own, but that way they're not gonna get any wrinkles or crinkles in them, and they cut so perfectly. This is so awesome. Let's go ahead and get our water bottles, and then I can show you how to put these on. I've got my water bottles. Now you can take the original labels off. You don't have to if you don't want to. I prefer to take them off, and I actually just like to cut a little slit and then kind of peel it off. I find that that works better for me. If you've got a little bit of like the glue left behind, totally fine, not worried about it. But all I'm gonna do is just pull these labels off of my bottles. That way they're out of my way. They're very staticky. And then what we'll do is I'm gonna show you two ways that you can put this on to your bottle, because it's super simple. It doesn't really take a lot of work or anything special. So one option is a double-sided crafter's tape. This stuff's great, works perfectly. So what you're gonna do is with your label, it's gonna fold over to this edge right here. This part will cover up that little edge. So you're gonna have it kind of sit like this. So you wanna put your double-sided tape on this side. So all I do is I use my little tape runner guy here. These things are great. I will link them down below. I love them for all sorts of like paper crafting, but they're really good for these as well. It works really good on your brochure paper. Then all I wanna do is I'm gonna set my bottle down and I'm gonna line up my design here and get it where I want it to sit on the bottle. That looks pretty good. And then all I wanna do is fold this over so that it covers that section. Now, your bottle is done. Super easy. Now, these ones do move around a little bit more than I prefer, but you can always use a little extra bit of this on to your bottle as well. So you can just put a little extra of like the sticky glue on parts of your bottle and that will help hold it as well. So that is an option. And then you can also use hot glue, which I'm waiting for that to warm up. So give that a moment. We'll warm that up and then I'll show you how to put the second one on. The hot glue is all heated up. Now, I don't love this one. This is the high and low temp gun. No matter what temp I put it on, it goobers out a bunch of glue. So it's not particularly my favorite one. But we'll do the same kind of idea where all we're gonna do is put some glue down here on this end. You don't need a lot. This is not my favorite way. I do prefer to do it with the double-sided tape. I just find that works a little bit better for me, but you do what works for you. So again, all I do is I line it up where I want it, which this one's sitting a little high, and I gotta work kind of quick because the glue dries. So I just need to kind of line that up best I can, and then simply, again, just place this down. Now this one, like I said, gets a little messier. I do prefer the double-sided tape version, but I find that this one holds a little bit tighter. So you do whatever one works for you. I'm gonna use the double-sided tape version on this, and this one I'm gonna put some tape around the bottle itself for this one, just so that it has a little more to grip to. And then again, I'm gonna go ahead and put the tape here. This is the easiest and honestly least messy way to do it. And then, like I said, I like to lay my bottle down, line it up. You guys probably saw the top of my head doing that. Line it up, and then I loop this guy around. I got this one sitting a little high, but that's okay, it's fine. And voila. So now you have these adorable water bottles, and I think they're so stinking cute. But again, this one's really loose, so I would recommend if you do the double-sided tape, you put it on the bottle. But I'm gonna get you guys a better view of these so that you can really see how they turned out.
These water bottles came out so stinking cute, and the brochure paper is perfect for this, but you can really use whatever you have. You could even use sticker paper if you wanted to, truly up to you, but I just wanted to use what I already had on hand and that I would like know worked really well. And using Canva for this is perfect. Remember that you can get the free template at corinneblackstone.com/waterbottle. I really wanted to make sure that you guys could do this super easy. And remember, do any theme that you want. It doesn't have to be Disney or whatever. You do the theme that fits with your party, your event. You could use pictures of your family, your friends, whoever's birthday it is. So go crazy, have fun, and just make something that you love. That's what I love about crafting, and I hope that you do too. Now, if you have any questions, be sure to leave those in the comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Make sure you're subscribed here. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content. It is totally free to subscribe. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.